slavery returns, African migrants are being sold at Libyan auctions, Hillary is responsible, Dems want this buried. For calling themselves the Progressive Party, the Democrats have taken Africans back in time to a period of human history we vowed would never happen again. Liberals blame Republican conservatives for racism, but everybody knows it was the Democratic Party that pushed for slavery and used white nationalism for more than a century to maintain power. What they don't want you to see, however, is that they still are for putting black people in chains and plantations. We aren't just talking about the Marxian welfare plantation, this is literally old-fashioned chattel slavery. CNN was the first to issue the shocking report that African migrants traveling to Europe are being captured and sold into slavery in Libyan markets. The footage they released exposed young African men being dragged out and auctioned off in the dead of night to be farm laborers, for the equivalent of $400 US each man. No doubt the liberal media pushed the story out in order to break the hearts of conservatives into becoming fanatical anti-border maniacs. But guess what? This horrific situation is all thanks to none other than anti-slavery, anti-racism, pro-immigration Hillary Rodham Clinton, but do you think the Clinton News Network ever even mentioned that? It was Hillary Clinton, during her term as Secretary of State, who convinced then-President Barack Obama and NATO to launch an invasion into Libya that toppled its leader, Colonel Muammar Gaddafi, in October 2011, which opened the power vacuum for terrorists, criminals, and slavers to drive the region into chaos. In 2003, under President George W. Bush, the U.S. made an arms agreement with Gaddafi, the Libyan regime gave up its weapons of mass destruction, and in return, we did not attack them. At least, until the pro-amnesty, pro-Obama regime took power and betrayed Africans by attacking him. How has Hillary coped with the guilt of having destroyed most of the African continent in the name of democracy? She's actually proud of it. "We came, we saw, he died," Clinton laughed, and has even used this humanitarian and cultural disaster of epical proportions, in the words of The Washington Post's Fred Hyatt, as evidence of her fitness to be President of the United States. Insane. The next time a liberal slams you as racist for not wanting these poor migrants in Europe and America, remind them it was Clinton, Obama, and the multicultural Democrats who made the call to destroy that country's relative law and order in the first place. Although Libya under Gaddafi was not the glimmering utopia of peace and stability, it was relatively more stable than the rest of Africa and the Middle East during the time. Even the woman-worshipping slime rag Huffington Post agrees the region was better with a dictator in power, than being a haven for jihadists, drug lords, and slave traders. Libya was a small country that posed no threat to the US and our allies, but, for whatever mysterious reason, Hussein Obama, who was elected exclusively on a no more Iraq's promise, went in like an imperialist and destroyed them. Even with his impossible level of arrogance, Obama has even admitted that invading Libya and failing to plan for the day after was the worst mistake of his presidency. There are even reports that the ongoing instability as a result of the invasion directly led to the attack on Benghazi, which caused the deaths of four Americans. In 2012, creepy Vice President Joe Biden told a group of black activists that the Republicans were going to put you all back in chains. Oh, really? Hillary won 88% of African American population's vote in the 2016 election, but if they ever saw this article, if Black Lives Matter knew the truth that Clinton and the Democrats are working to put Africans back in chains and plantations, not the Republicans, liberals will never take another black vote ever again. The Republican Party is the party of Abraham Lincoln. "Not bad," said then-presidential candidate Donald Trump, outside of Seattle, Washington. "It's also the party of freedom, equality and opportunity. It is the Democratic Party that is the party of slavery, the party of Jim Crow." Donald Trump was referring to information from Dinesh D'Souza's book and film, Hillary's America, which goes into further depth regarding Clinton and the Democrat Party's true connections to African American slavery. If you are just as appalled at the Democrats' enslavement of Africans, please like, comment, and share this article all over the internet.